Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent, the Most Merciful. I went to Majlis and Hussain but couldn't weep. My body was there, my soul asleep. O Allah, help me attain this noble deed, for crying for Hussain purifies the heart indeed. I pray that I at least shed a tear. Surely these are means to make us near. Having a heart of stone is what I fear. How can I not cry for someone so dear? Perhaps I don't love them as much, or is it I don't understand them as such? The sacrifices they made, the wisdom they gave, showed us how to truly be God's humble slave. It took a lot, they gave what not. How ignorant of me, have I forgot? The Zib-e-Azim in Quran, that ransomed divine plan, how Hussain fulfilled, relinquishing him and his clan. The yearning of his companions with that zeal to die, our lives be sacrificed for you, did roar and cry. His honor Muhammad ready to be slayed, and Abbas's anguish at being delayed. Pierce dagger in chest of his beloved Akbar, that blood in his hands of his six-month Asghar, concealing the pieces of Qasim's body from his mother's eyes. Without hands by Farad, his Abbas lies. O Baba, you please don't go, now wails his daughter. Her thirst has died, Sakina no longer wants water. She pleads to lay for the one last time on her dad's chest. After this, her ears will bleed and her cheeks be red. There's a whisper then in her ears. She now lets Hussain go while still in tears. This parting till death shall make her cry. Her lips shall now be always dry. These trials and tests only get tougher. Words cannot describe what they suffer. The loneliness of Hussain as he departs to attack. The enemies get terrified. They run and retract. He calls to his martyred comrades, come see my battle. Look how I make these fasiks rattle. But it's time for Hussain to take that promised fall. He hears from Surah Fajr his Lord's call. O ye my beloved, you tranquil soul, return to me, your ultimate goal. You're pleased with me, I'm pleased with you. Enter my Jannah, your family is awaiting you. Hussain now ascends to martyrdom's highest station, revealing the purest form of God's manifestation. Zainab is in tears, the blessed heads are on spears. Their camps are on fire, being uprooted. Bales from their heads are also looted. Sajjad is there, but unable to care. His father has died, and his hands are tied. He looks at the blessed body in despair. O dad, how unfortunate is your heir, to see you lay on the ground like this, and not even be able to hug or kiss. By God, this is such a difficult test. How can one not but beat his chest? The hearts of believers shall always lament, commemorating forever this magnanimous event. Though rulers for times have tried to prevent, the remembrance of Hussain continues to transcend. Centuries have passed, but memories remain so vivid. Oceans of marcias and tributes continues to be flooded. Masses are fed, tears are shed. The mourning for Hussain is so blessed. It surely is a part of our Prophet's tradition. Tears are the blessings of his daughter's petition. She shall turn them to jewels when we die. Tears are our investments on which we rely. Tears shall indeed set us apart. It cleanses the stains from the heart. Were it not for tears, how else would we show our offerings of mawaddat, which makes hearts glow? Tears are proof of extreme devotion. Tears are the epitome of love and emotion. Tears in gratitude, tears in grief. Tears provide the ultimate relief. Tears are like water that makes plants grow. It nourishes our souls and makes goodness flow. Tears of empathy this world direly needs. Without it, surely the society recedes. Tears are the fulfillment of Zahra's desire. Tears of Aza are for what we aspire. In the love of Ahlul Bayt, the tears we impart is how we experience divinity from the heart. So next time, Ali Hasan, you cannot weep. Pray Allah awakens what within you is asleep. That godliness in your heart that lies so deep, which tears for salvation shall make you reach. Which tears for salvation shall make you reach.